THC, 1 upon 10, sub, ENTHS. Now we are moving on to 1 upon 100, that is 100 sub, HUNTREDPHS. This is only one part out of total 100. So 1 upon 100, as you can see, this is a simple fraction form. So how to convert it to decimal? It's very easy. I'll take an example of standard unit to explain further of 1 upon 100 or 100 sub. Okay, now you know that the 1 meter always makes 100 centimeter. Right? 1 meter makes 100 centimeter. So now convert 25 centimeter into meter. See, now whenever we convert smaller in unit, that is centimeter is smaller, and into the bigger unit, that is meter, there is always a division of the given units. Now, you know that 1 meter makes 100 centimeter. So, how about 25 centimeter will make meters, right? I need to convert centimeter into meter. So, this is the standard form what we write. 1 meter makes 100 centimeter. So, what about 25 centimeter will give how many meters? So, against the number which is having a question mark, we go into the numerator and denominator, we have 100 as they are in the same unit, but one is on the upper side and one is on the lower side. So 100 will go into the denominator. So 25 upon 100. So in total, how many digits we have in 100? 3. Right? And in the numerator, we have 2. So I have to add 0 before 25 to make the digits same. That is 3 in the numerator and 3 in the denominator. Now I made it similar. 0 to 5. Now how many zeros are there in 100? 2. So count from the right 2 digits. 1 and 2. And dots, so your answer is 0.525 meter. Okay, now from this we are moving on to exercise 8.2 on page 173 of your textbook. Question number 1, you can see there is a table along with the diagrams is given. You have to complete the given table. Now you can see there are 3 diagrams, A, B and C. In the first, see in the table they had given ones, T10s, that is 1 upon 10, and 100s, that is 1 upon 100, and you have to write the number. Okay, so I begin with the first. As you can see, there are no full squares are covered. So that means, as we are not having any of the full square covered, that means in ones, that is before decimal point, we do not have any number in one. So we kept it 0. Okay, now you can see this rows, these columns are of 10 boxes. They are 10, right? So how many 10s are there? You can count it, this two, this black dotted two lines, right? They are of, each line is of 10 boxes. So this is 10 1 and this is 10 2. So this is after decimal point, that is how many boxes, how many lines are there that is having black circles or dots in all the boxes? There are 2, so 2 tens. And see, you can see this is halfly filled. There is only 6 black circles you can see in the small squares, and the rest 4 are without the black circles. So that means this 6 what you see here are hundreds. So you will write 6 in the hundreds column. Similarly, the second one, B. In B, you can see 2 figures are given. One is fully covered with black dots, right? So that means this hole is covered, there is a whole number. So one whole box, that means one will come in the ones place value, that is before decimal point. In the same way, how many fully covered lines are there containing 10 black dots? There is 1, 2, 3. So these 3 will come into tens place value in the place value table. And the rest, the fourth line, you can see it is not fully covered. 2 boxes are still left to be colored with black dots. So that total 8 dots are seen in the hundreds. So 8 is in the place value of hundreds table, place value table. In the same way, C, the one whole full box is covered, that will go into ones place value. These 2 whole lines are covered with black dots, that is 2 tens. So 2 in the tens column, and the rest, there are 8 dots, will come into the hundreds column. So 1.28. I hope this is clear to you. Okay, coming on to the question number 2, you have to simply write the numbers in the decimal form from the table. Right? The first one, you can see in hundreds we have 0, in tens we have 0, ones we have 3, tens we have 2, hundreds we have 5 and thousands we have 1. Okay, so now the decimal number will be 00, we never write, so 3.25. The numbers which are given before this whole number zeros, if it is given, we will not write. And at the end, if the number of zeros are given, we will not write. But in between where there are zeros, we have to write the zeros. Please remember, the second number is 102.63. See, the last is given zero, so we will not write zero. The third C is 30.025. D is 211.9, that is 9 is in the place value of tens, that is 1 upon 10, hundreds, 1 upon hundreds is 0, and 1 upon thousands is 2. So 902, and the last is 12.241. Hopefully this is clear to you. We will continue later exercise 8.2. Thank you.